Palestinians haven't had a lot to celebrate recently, but they do now. Mohammed Asaf won the Arab Idol singing competition Saturday. The 23-year-old Gazan impressed fans in his final act with a nationalist anthem inspiring people from Gaza to the West Bank and beyond. CNN's Mohammed Jamjoon joins us now from CNN Beirut with more. It is an amazing story. This young unknown embraced first by his neighbors, his community, and now, it seems, by virtually the entire Arab world.
That's right, Jonathan. You know, Arab Idol is the Middle Eastern version of American Idol. It is a sensation, and it's really become the feel-good story of the year. It's given this strife-ridden region a reason to smile. Mohammed Asaf's victory, you know, we were there last night. The crowd went absolutely wild, and his journey has been about so much more than just a singing competition.
He's given Arabs something to smile about. Palestinians, a reason to be proud. When Mohammed Asaf, a 23-year-old from Gaza, was crowned this year's Arab Idol, they went wild in the studio and celebrated in the streets.
Look, you see, everybody going crazy.
Everybody's happy.
Everybody's happy. This is the best thing to happen to Palestine since God knows when.
In Ramallah, an eruption of euphoria. They chanted his name, danced in his honor, set off fireworks. I'm very, very happy, says this young girl. I can't wait for him to come here. I'm so excited. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. An outpouring of emotion. In Gaza, it was gridlock. Mohammed's hometown came to a standstill while Palestinians partied. An extremely festive atmosphere for a population unaccustomed to happy endings. With an incredible voice and an inspirational story, it didn't take long for Mohammed to become a heartthrob and a hero. He made the difficult journey out of Gaza, but still barely made it to the tryouts in Cairo. Another contestant heard him sing and decided to give up his number so Mohammed could audition. Charming audiences and judges early on, he was nicknamed The Rocket and became a fan favorite, singing patriotic Palestinian songs. The former wedding singer told me he was overwhelmed and humbled, that he just lived the happiest moment of his life. An artist is made by his fans, he tells me. The love of your fans is better than all the money in the world. There's nothing better. And I feel like today, that's what I won. On stage after his big win, Mohammed was draped in a Palestinian flag, dedicating the victory to his people. He said he still couldn't believe his luck, but more than anything, he wants his success to challenge negative stereotypes, insisting Palestinians can overcome their dire economic and political circumstances. The Palestinian people can speak in a million languages full of beauty, love, and peace to the Arab world and to the whole world, he says. The Palestinian people don't love wars and killing and destruction. It's clear now the rocket has launched. Mohammed Asaf is soaring to stardom, hoping against hope that when Palestinians hear his voice, they'll finally feel they have a voice.
And Jonathan, just to underscore what an incredible story Mohammed Asaf has, when he got to Cairo, when he finally got out of Gaza and got to Cairo, not only was he late for the auditions, not only did he almost miss his chance, but in order to get into the hotel to audition, he had to scale a wall and he had to evade security to get in before he could start singing and have somebody give him his number so that he could try out. Jonathan?
It's amazing. I mean, it's such a story about one young man's achievement against all odds. And when you tell the story, we're reminded of it time and again. Couldn't get in, got there late, got help from another competitor who decided not to compete against him. You can see the impact in Gaza. You can see the impact in the Palestinian areas. But it's got to be resonating even more widely than that.
Absolutely. And that's one of the reasons this show, Arab Idol, has become such a success. We just talked a minute ago about how there's so much strife in the region right now. Well, this show is all about music, not misery. And Arab viewers have really been cheering for the contestants. In a post-Arab Spring world, the three finalists were an Egyptian, a Syrian, and then Mohammed Asaf, a Palestinian who beat the odds. Now, I spoke with Lebanese superstar singer Nancy Ajram, who's also one of the judges of Arab Idol, asked her why the show was so special last night. Here's what she told me.
Arab Idol showed to the whole world that we in the Arab world have young, bright, and talented people, and we know how to dream big.
And again, Jonathan, we were there last night. The audience was ecstatic. You saw the scenes from Gaza to Mullah, and we've heard of so many other celebrations across the Arab world. Really just something to smile about here in this part of the world. Jonathan.
It's a really moving story. Mohammed Jam Jr. in Beirut, thanks very much.